So welcome back everybody to another Farming Simulator video, and we're going to carry on in this episode with the harvest. And I can't actually remember what else we had planned, but in fact we can turn auto combo, combine off as, well not off completely, but we can turn it off the headland mode as it's done about I think 2 or 3. So that's, as you can see, it's plenty enough for it to turn round. And it's going that way, I think. Although it'll change every time it goes up and down, so I don't know. It should be fine. So we'll let that do its thing. We were actually doing the grass last episode. We didn't finish it off, obviously, but we're going to do that this episode. So we'll get on with that. Why is it not touching? Is it this again? I had this problem when I was trying to use it for mowing. Although it shouldn't affect this because it's like a trailer type thing. Oh no. It's working. Good. So we'll get this done. And then I think we need to row it all up. And probably bale it as well. I don't know if we'll get it all done in the same episode, but it doesn't really matter if we don't. Just get a nice screenshot. So this is working quite well. It doesn't need loads of power, I don't think. So I know the Unimog's not struggling at all. I don't know how many bales we'll get out of this. We should get quite a few, but they'll be square bales. And then we can, once we've finished the silage off, which might be a bit tomorrow's episode, just finishing that field, there's only a little bit to do, then we can start fermenting the silage, so that'll be good. Then we can move on to the cows, so it's like a little bit of a chain reaction. We have to get all the stuff done, you know, to move on. I think we'll probably do some really big harvests. Get a bigger harvester. Maybe try planting some trees. Because I think you can sell them on this map, I'm not sure. We'll keep this going. And we'll start going up and down after I've done this loop. So we'll just lift that up. And we'll back into the corner. That's not good. I like the textures in this map. It's not like Willow Tree Farm. Willow Tree made it really yellow and I thought that were a bit unrealistic, but I think this is a bit more realistic. Definitely the colours. And I know the real light mod does affect it a little bit. It doesn't look too bad, I don't think. Now this shouldn't take long at all, actually. I don't think we should do the rowing up with this. Not because it can't handle it, I think it probably can quite easily. It's just the scale of it would be, I think, too offset. Because in real life, if it's the same one that I've seen, probably about 4 miles from where I live, it's absolutely massive. It's like bigger than most tractors, so that was like a Unimog type thing, so I think it might be a little bit off scale. I don't know. fact, what we could do is let's do this. That's it. All working well. Missed a little bit there. I'll have to get it at the end. Probably only a few more runs now up there. We'll be finished. This Unimog's starting to get dirty actually. Which is quite good. Don't think I... Because when it came out, it wouldn't actually download from the website. The Farm Sim website. So I had to wait until it was put on, I don't know what it was put on, like FS UK or something, and then it still wouldn't work. Then I found another website with it on, then I got it off there. I don't know why it didn't work, just some mods don't work off FS website. Like the official website. But that's probably just for me, I don't know. If it's for everyone. Well, if it were for everyone, they would have fixed it, I suppose. I don't think I was doing anything wrong, though, so... A bit of a mystery. Right, I don't know for definite, but out of this field, I reckon we'll get... maybe 20 bales, maybe more, maybe 30. Or could even be less. Don't think I'll get all of it. Oh yeah, I will. Yep. Getting it all in one run. Apart from that up there and that little bit. Now tell me in the comments if you like that weight on the front, if it looks good. I know Landy Kid has some that look good. They're like, I don't know what they're for, but they're just little black ones. I suppose I could get some of them, but I like the concrete one, but it is a little bit too heavy. Like, it flicks the back end up when you hook it up. I'll show you what I mean once I've folded this. So, fold it. And I'll just drop that. Perfect. You see that? And it does this. So, might be a little bit too heavy, but it does the job, I suppose. If it was just a little bit narrower, it might be nice. Shouldn't drive through the crop. And if anyone's wondering where I got them from, I can't tell you because I went on a multiplayer server and the guy had these mods, so I just downloaded them. And yeah, that's where I got them from, so I don't actually know where, you know, he got them from. Them trailers need to go away actually. I could do that with the Unimog. I always think it's that shed there, but it's always round the back. Now, I'm not going to try this through the mirrors. In fact, this could go in the end one. Oh, no, we'll just leave it in this one. Put the tedders behind the tedders. Because that little one, I don't think we'll ever use it, but there's no point selling it. Just in case we ever need to do a little bit. Or a really small field. That'll do me. It's in the shed. We'll run this back. We don't actually have a slurry tanker, I don't think. On this map, we'll have to. I like some modded ones, but I want like a really big one with like tires the size of that tractor on the back. Maybe like a scratched one or something like that. Where could these trailers go actually? Oh, I know where. They'd probably be better down at the other storage bit. You know, where you keep the grain and that. Probably be a bit more sensible place to put them, but I'm thinking I'd drop that one and just back them up here for the time being. It's a little yard this, and I do like the layout. It's just obviously with every yard you could tweak it, even with like Cobra Farm at Cobra Park Farm. You know, the yard can be a little bit small, and I think this one's a little bit small when you have quite a lot of machinery, but it, you know, it's manageable. Probably just me not managing it that well. They could actually go in that field, but I'm just going to put them right up against the hedge so that they're not causing any problems. Them bales, I'll probably use them first. It's just because they weren't like in a stack, they were just two that were left over, so I just put them to the side. And I've still not heard anything from Alex, so I don't know if he's going to be joining us again. I don't see why not. I think he's just really busy. It'll probably be next weekend if I get any footage with him. Now that gate's really annoying. If it were me, I would have made that contactless, because I've hit it a few times. There we go. So just drop these. Hopefully not the weight. There we go. Now, that's not doing any harm there. We'll probably need to empty the combine because I haven't got this up. The information thing. And it stopped on the wrong side, what a shame. Let that unload. I can put that back on actually, so we know. I think I did download actually. This isn't going to be unloading when we're on this, but oh, have we not got it? I thought I downloaded the combine pack, New Holland one, but obviously not. I think we've got this one. That one's like the next one up. This one. We could probably afford that once we sell it, but 10,000 litres, 4,000. Oh my god, what have I just bought? Oh my god. Oh, I've just bought another little combine. Like an idiot. Now, what do I do? Keep it or sell it? To be honest, what's the biggest field in this map? No, wrong thing now. Nine. Yeah, there is some really big fields, and we could do with a bigger combine. Right, we were on 200,000. So what I'm going to do is I'll write this down. So I've written 200,000 down, and we're at 52 now. So whatever we make from these, from tipping this load, I'll add back in. Right, where are we going with this actually? We need to go Is it left or right? I need to go right. A little tight, but we got round. So it's a bit of a bad decision that, but shouldn't take me long to add money back in if I can remember how to do it. Alex did show me, but I think I forgot. I'll figure it out anyway. So there was 200k just over. Well, in fact, 202. And then 2700. Right. So, when we do this, I'll write this down as well. Just so that we're playing, you know, with the right amount of money. I shouldn't have messed that up, to be honest. So we'll just dump this. And if you don't already know why I'm driving through the fence there, it's because it's a nightmare to get in and out, so I'm not doing it at all now. So this shouldn't... Oh, hang on, we're getting quite a good price from this. What are we at? We're at 52. £11,500. So I've written that down. So I need to make sure there's... Just get around this corner. When I add it back up, I need to make sure that there's... Oh, what would that be? About 214. I'll put 215 in, something like that. Now this is must be where it's quite intensive because you can't run two mirrors, I don't know why. It's not like it's showing much in the mirror anyway. But anyway, we'll carry on. We should probably buy that field as well, that's a good field to buy. It's got the straw in it and, you know, it's just quite a good field, that, quite square. And we own 16 as well. I could have gone in that entrance actually, I didn't know that were there. It's nearly full. Hopefully it'll turn round. Yeah, it is doing. Quite a steep hill actually on there. I think that's an element for FS17 is, you know, private number plates, not like the mods have, but like proper private number plates. Now why is it not working? Am I too close? Nope. We'll go on to see. Is it stuck on the fence? Possibly, yeah. Restart that. I think it's just because it couldn't finish its action then. Oh, well, the trailer has slid. Because that was straight and it's actually slid. What was that? Open the door. How do you do that? Well, now you can do it from inside. If it gets a little bit hot. Best one that I like is this one. No, I need that one. There we go. Fully ventilated. And we can actually leave the tractor because it's on this side, it's not in the crop. If I actually parked it under the right spot. Right, what do we need to do now? Can't remember what we're going to do. Oh. Can use this guy to rake it all up. What do you call it, rake or raw? That doesn't look like it's fully... There we go. Didn't think that would fully shut. We just got out there. Anyway, we'll head wherever we're supposed to be going. Where is that? Can't remember what field I've cut. Was it field 2? I think so. Oh yeah, it's through there. Yeah, we should have gone the other way. Don't matter, we can go on the road. Whoa. Well, that's not very realistic. Flying all over the place. I think that's one of the problems with this mod. I think when I was using it on Willow Tree quite a lot actually. And when I was using it, it was slipping with the seeding. So we'll get this unfolded. I don't know, I just reversed and I could have just drove forward. But anyway, we'll start on this. Get it as neat as we can. Probably do the headland last, actually. Oh, I thought that would be contactless, as everything else is. I will admit that's because I was looking at my phone. But it's alright because it was a notification off YouTube. Get a nice curve on here. No, it didn't go that well. Now that weren't that close. God. It kicks it out when that happens. Kicks a line out. Now I'm driving in the hedge a little bit because I know some of it did go in the hedge, so that's a bit justified. I know this gate's got a contact on. And it's a stubborn one. I do try and be realistic, it's just sometimes, you know, I want to get somewhere, or, you know, just make life easier. And I said I was going to go up and down, actually. What I'm going to do is just back up a bit. I don't think they do, but if it, oh, I didn't miss that much. That's got to be a glitch. I cannot have missed that much. In fact, I definitely didn't. That's just appeared, that. And it, I bet you a bloody fiver it don't row up. It won't accept it or something. Bloody hell. I hate it when it does that. I wish the front had come up first, like, you know, more than they do. I wonder where the number plate is on this thing. I don't think it has one, actually. It should be, like, there or something. Now we'll see if it rows it up. I don't think it will though. You're just covering it. Uh-huh. Could be. No, I think it's just covering it. Working quite well, actually. Not amazingly neat, as you can see, but it'll do. And then we'll bale it up next episode, collect all the bales, and probably start feeding the sheep. Oh no, now we've got sales to do. But we can still feed the sheep. I meant the cows. I actually hit the wrong button there. I reckon the New Hollander run this tool. Or implement. Now that is going to be a pain and it's not going to go in warm. It's not even going to be a thingy with. Ah, that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to keep the speed up when you pick them up. That's what I was doing wrong. I was going to merge them two together then, but I thought, no, we'll keep it as one. If you see what I mean now, when I Press that. Oh, no, it didn't work. But if the front ones just came up a little bit quicker, then it would be much easier. You wouldn't like end up merging like that. But anyway, we've finished it off for today. We'll take this back to the farm. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed. I hope what you've seen has been good. Or what am I gonna say then? I'm gonna say I hope you agree with what I've done. But yeah, I hope you've all enjoyed, and hopefully I'll see you in the next episode, which will be tomorrow, where we'll be baling that field, collecting them, and finishing off with silage. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.